Welcome to episode 4 of Kitchen Karate. Each other, organic, right? Us! Let's get started. For our warm-up today, we're going to do push-ups, some different sit-ups, and some squats with kicks. Let's start with those push-ups. And down, remember, you can do it from this position, or you can bring your knees down on the ground as you work your way up to being able to bring those knees up off the ground. You can go open hand, you could try fist with your two knuckles right here on the ground. I recommend doing that one on carpet or something soft, or today I'm gonna try fingertips. You can pause the video now to do your 10. Awesome, now we're gonna roll over. The sit-up we're gonna do today called Row the Boat. We pretend we're out, sun is shining, can see the beach, it's beautiful, and you're out in your little rowboat. You're gonna bring your legs up off the ground, hands are at the side. Each time you row, you pull your arms back, kick your legs out, and then come back in. Ready? We're gonna do 10 of these. You can pause the video. Nice job. Oh, what's that? Shark in the water. 10 more, as fast as you can. Think we got away. All right, next exercise, we're up. Okay, starting with our squat. We've done this before. Hands up, we come down. Elbows touch the knees, but this time when we come back up, we're gonna practice our kick. Remember, when you come up into your kick, just sweep up, heel kicks your butt, kick out, come back, heel kicks your butt, foot down. Each time we do one, we kick with the opposite leg. So we're gonna do 10 of those. Ready? Great, that's our workout for today. For our stretch today, we're going to be sitting. We're going to start by touching our toes. So right now, if you see, legs are flat on the ground. As I reach out, try and touch my toes. I'm just going to hold that. Feel that nice stretch. And slowly come up, shake it out. Now we're going to try and reach a little bit further, as far as you can. If you can, try and grab the sides of your feet. Ankles as far as you can get. Still keeping those legs flat. Just hold that there. Slowly up. Now we're gonna spread our legs out. There we go, start by reaching out in front of you. Just gonna bring your elbows down to the floor and hold it. And you're gonna bring your hands out a little bit further, and then try and bring your elbows back down to the floor without moving your hands. And then hold. Last time, as far as you can. And then try and bring those elbows down. And slowly back up. All right. Our next stretch, we're gonna bring our left hand under our leg. Right hand's gonna come over, reaching for those toes. See if you can grab your foot. Slowly come up. Other side now, hand goes under, then try and straighten that leg again. And you're gonna reach over top of your body. Try and touch those toes. Just hold that there. Good. And come up. All right, let's move on. We're gonna quickly go through the fundamentals that we've learned before. You wanna make sure you're practicing these throughout the week. So our first fundamental, yokoyuke, side defense. Bring it up like this, and we're gonna do 10. Excellent. Then our next fundamental we did, kianzuki, our punch from parallel stance. Let's do 10. Then our next fundamental, we did our kicks. So kozugeri nigi and kozugeri hidari, our right and left high kick. Remember, you can also do the maigeri, so you can kick to the stomach as you're working to get up to that chin height for your high kicks. So let's do 10 each side of those. And our new one that we learned last week, shuto, sword punch. Let's do 10 of those. Great job on your fundamentals. Okay, so today I also want to show you some stances that we do in karate. So the first stance we're going to look at today is shiko stance. So to get into my shiko stance, you can start with your heels together in our open-toed stance. And then I'm going to bring my right leg out like this. So I'm stepping that far and then I'm dropping down. So to get your feet into the right position for your shiko stance, start with your feet together. Pivot your toes out with your heels touching. So this is like our ready position when we're opening. And I bring my heels out, so now I'm in my parallel stance. Toes out again. Standing over my heels all the way out wide. And then finally, my toes come out. So once you've walked out your position, you can also check if you have a mirror, you want to see that your knees are right above your feet. And I don't want my legs too far out like that. I also don't want them in like this. So knees straight down to my feet. My feet are angled out like this. I want to push my knees back. And if I look at the side, I don't want my knees coming forward like that. It's like I'm sitting down and then I just tuck my pelvis in. So from my knees straight down to my feet, just like that. So we're just gonna hold our shiko stance. So you can cross your arms, just hold that position. You're gonna be feeling that in here a little bit. You're building the muscles right now. You're also building that muscle memory to know where the stance is and how to get into it. While we're here, why don't we practice a few of our punches? There we go, hands are out. From this backhand, I want it nicely tucked in, my elbows tucked in, not out like this. Bring that fist up high in our style. Not down like this. Different styles of karate, they have their fists lower. Goju, our fists are up high. Itch. Nice slow punches. Knee. Really feel the burn of the stance. Sun. Ji. Go. Rook. Seach. Touch. Ku. Ju. Good job. And I think we're about ready to hold it for about 10 more seconds. Doing well. Awesome. And that one. Good job holding that stance. So today for our special skills, we're gonna go way back to Japan before karate was even a thing and look at ninjutsu. So I'm sure you've seen ninjas and samurai in movies and things like that. Well, they're real. And ninjas, sometimes we think of them all just dressed up in black, sneaking around in the night. But really, they were more like spies working for different lords around Japan. And most of the time, they would blend in just by dressing like locals. They might be dressed like a farmer or something like that. So that's how they really would blend in. But we're going to practice some of their sneaky moving skills just for fun. So when you're being sneaky, it's all about being quiet. And when you're trying to move quiet, you have to go slow. So really slow. So you can practice moving around your house really slow. You might have a creaky floor like I do. So you have to be really careful about knowing where the creaks are and go slow. You can practice maybe by sneaking up on somebody at home. That's all for today. So practice your fundamentals. Make sure you're practicing your exercises and stretching. And have fun practicing your ninja skills, sneaking up on people at home. Each other. Are you got it right? Us. See you next time.